how nicely we've come to the end of 2018. And suddenly I feel that as if the year has just flushed by. Did we have time to stop and think? Did we have time to rejuvenate? Did we have time to reflect on what we had done in 2017? Because 2019 is a harbinger and a follow-up of whatever seeds we have actually sown in 2017 or 2018. Now, what does this December hold for us? Now, this is my probably the last monthly prediction for 2018, because soon I am going to be telling you all what exactly you should be doing in 2019 so that the reaps are bountiful and you can have abundance of health, wealth and happiness. Pisces, December 2018 for you will continue to give priority to your health until the 22nd. Review what we have wrote, what I've been telling you last month. Enhance health by paying more attention to your liver, thighs, spine, knees and your skeletal alignment. You seem as much concerned with your health as your career, and you need to do some physical exercise and look into the diet that you're having. You also would be concerned about the health of a parent figure and your friends. Personal health improves dramatically after the 22nd. Most of the planets are still above the horizon, and your 10th house of career will remain strong. Much career success is happening now, but through the old-fashioned way, which means work hard and you will succeed. There is some travel related to work and career also this month. Perhaps you will take work-related courses or seminars as well. All of this is good as it makes you more valuable. Home and family issues can safely be de-emphasized for now. 70 to 80% of the planets are now in the east. Uranus is moving back into your sign at the end of the month. This is the time to make positive personal changes and to take control of your own life and affairs and to create things in a way that you want them to be. Your social popularity is still strong, and if you are not rude or arrogant to others, your efforts will not detract you from your popularity. They might even enhance it. Finances remain tricky throughout. On one hand, you have a lot of financial drive and desire, but perhaps your haste and zeal are bringing about opposition in others. Perhaps they threaten your status quo. Make haste slowly, otherwise it will be a waste. Earnings will come, but you will have to work harder for them. Mars moves into your money house on the 16th, enhancing prosperity and helps you develop fearlessness in finance. Better to make few mistakes and overcome fear than to stay paralyzed by fear and do nothing. This is a period for financial activism. Only do it slowly and carefully. Love remains happy, but Uranus moves into your own sign, which poses important philosophical questions for you. Do you want a committed relationship or do you want personal independence? You can't have both, as they are mutually exclusive. Perhaps you can have a little of each. Perhaps you can alternate between periods of serious love and periods of personal freedom, which actually requires communication skills. So you need to make your loved ones understand that you need your space as much as you need time with them also. But this is the conundrum you are facing these days. Pisces, sometimes the limitation of personal freedom leads to other kinds of freedom. The freedom from worrying who your date will be on New Year's Eve, the freedom to pursue other interests without worrying about love, the freedom that you want in any kind of form has to be conveyed. But before you convey, you must realize it and get your priorities correct, that what is the kind of freedom that you are seeking. The retrograde of your love planet from the 17th onwards will give you time to clarify your thinking. So clarify your thoughts before the new year sets in, and you can execute it as you bring in the new year. For your best days overall, for your most stressful days, or your best days for love and for your money and honey, you'll have to visit my website, And remember, these are all generic predictions for zodiacs, but to get your personalized chart made and knowing where your planets are situated and what are the mahadasas that are going to do to you, it's very important that 2019 should be a reflection of yourself. So to start the 2019 with great gusto, get your natal charts made, know where your planets are and how good they hold for you and what are the things that you need to negate and how you can mastermind your mahadasas.